afraid of the dark? Are you scared? You know, I am you.
Hi, and welcome to Cinema Figures. I'm your host, Caitlin, and today is the start of my Octogrr marathon. Yeah, that's right, you heard it right, Octogrr. Grr. Anywho, so this is my marathon of some of my favorite horror movies, some of my favorite Halloween films, and just some great seasonal frights and creepy kind of things thrown in there. So very, very excited to share all of those with you. So without further ado, we are going to talk about one of my favorite horror films of all time, and that is Trick or Treat. So Trick or Treat, Trick or Treat, Trick or Treat. Trick or Treat is the movie that seemed to have been talked about for years, that always was just coming up. And then it just kind of came out direct to DVD, and a big reason for that is the fear throughout a lot of different production companies. Trick or Treat deals with a lot of violence, a lot of gore, a lot of, I think some of the most outrageous things that we see in this is the violence against children. There are quite a few kids that die in this movie. So, I mean, mainstream audiences, they seem to think, you know, you go see a horror movie that the kids are at least safe. Yeah, no one's safe in Trick or Treat, not really. If you don't respect the holiday and its traditions, then you're kind of screwed, because my boy Sam's going to deal with you. So Trick or Treat is very similar to a lot of other Halloween horror films, like All Hallows Eve and Tales of Halloween, things like that, where it's an anthology piece. It's a collection of short stories. However, Trick or Treat is very different from All Hallows Eve because it actually has all of the stories intertwine and various characters are thrown into each other's storylines throughout. So definitely very dynamic there. Also, we do have a for real frickin' cast in this one. I mean, it's basically a who's who of some A-list, a lot of B-list, a lot of really great actors and actresses that you don't necessarily think you're going to see in horror films that much, but here they are, and they're giving it their all. So, of course, the five different storylines we do get to see here are a couple after a long night, you know, up out on the town during Halloween, and they're disputing whether or not to put the decorations up. Of course, they're both very intoxicated, and what needs to happen there. So the husband does end up going back to bed, opting to watch their videotape. Yeah, that's right. And the wife is actually outside still trying to clean up the front yard, where she encounters our big bad, our star of the film. That's Sam, if you can see him behind me in all of his glory from Trick or Treat Studios. And Sam doesn't take too kindly to just anyone who disrespects his favorite holiday. And let's just say she had a bite of a sucker. We'll put it that way. So connecting on to the second big storyline, we get to meet our high school principal. See, middle school, is he high school? I don't know. He's a school principal. His name is Mr. Wilkins. And, you know, on the surface, he just seems like a boring principal, you know, there to keep track of things, keep everything in line. Yeah, well, this principal, he has a secret. His secret is he likes to kill people. So if it isn't just poisoning kids' candy, it's chasing down unsuspecting, intoxicated young women and biting them as if you were a vampire. He has a pit full of bodies in his backyard, and he is teaching his young son, which, by the way, tell me Charlie Wilkins isn't the cutest frickin' kid in a horror movie, like, ever. This is, like, the most adorable child ever. I will put him right next to the teenager that we had in Halloween 2018. Can't remember that character's name right now. But I will put them side by side because they are both adorable. Yes, yes. But learning how to carve out the eyes on a jack-o'-lantern. So that scene is just grotesque. Gosh. I don't want to spoil it for you if you haven't seen it. If you haven't seen it before, why the heck are you wasting your time here? Watch that movie because that movie is fantastic. But the third movie, or the third storyline in our movie, is a group of kids, and they're going to put together a prank. So they've decided to go after Rhonda, who they refer to as retard Rhonda, but she's not. She's actually an idiot savant. So, of course, she's a little bit different, and they decide that they're going to play a prank on her. So they start off by telling her the story of these different students on the school bus and how they died. They died going off the cliff of a rock quarry. Now, of course, they're saying, oh, you're just trying to scare us, da-da-da-da. Only their prank goes a little too far. Rhonda actually ends up getting hurt during their prank. And it's not actually until they destroy the last of the jack-o'-lanterns that they have that they actually find out exactly how real that whole story is and exactly how screwed they are. So the first time I saw that scene, I was not expecting those sound effects. That is the stuff of nightmares. These kids being ripped apart and screaming, gurgling, and just sounds. You cannot get scarier than that. And the fact that this film, yes, it does have a lot of gore, it does have a lot of carnage, but the fact that this film alludes to so many things is definitely, I think, it's a strong point. It shows you enough, but the implied horror is some of the scariest stuff in this entire movie. So there's also a story that involves a group of college girls, which two of which are actual sisters, one of which is Anna Paquin, and I gotta tell you, I don't think she's ever looked prettier before because she is gorgeous in this movie. So, we find out that the girls are all teasing Anna Paquin's character, Lori, because she's a virgin. 22-year-old virgin. And it's Halloween, so she needs to get busy getting busy, apparently. And all the other girls are like, hey, we're gonna go out in slutty costumes and find ourselves some dates. So, fun little factoid for anyone who was unaware. The scene where the girls are trying on their Halloween costumes and trying to slut it up for the evening, because why not? It's Halloween. We've all been there. But that scene, the little boy who's actually peeping in on the girls is the same child actor they had inside of the Sam costume for several of the scenes throughout the film. So, same kid. Just saying. This is actually very sharp. I need to quit touching that point. It is very sharp. But of course, she does go out on her own. She is going to find a date. And there's a lot of things thrown into this film throughout. There was a reference throughout the prank gone wrong storyline where Rhonda and the pirate kid, I forget what his name is, it doesn't really matter, but they hear howls. And Rhonda exclaims that it's werewolves. And the sisters, referring to one of the other as the runt of the litter, and the big bad wolf lines that we hear later on with, my, what big eyes you have. Well, there are actually a pack of female werewolves, and Halloween is apparently their night to go crazy and kill a bunch of guys. So that is exactly what you're referring to as far as her being a virgin. But definitely you can see a lot of parallels there between just really crazy, like, sexual stuff and, you know, tearing a bunch of guys apart as werewolves. And I gotta tell you, if you've never seen that scene, I would highly suggest not watching it with someone that you'd be uncomfortable watching that kind of scene with, because let's just say lap dances, nudity, and kind of oddly sexual gore. But still very well shot, very well done. And Lori's first kill is actually our principal from before. So, you know, another tie-in to our storylines. And the last of the stories we actually see is involving an elderly man in his home. He is not a fan of Halloween. He is home alone, well, home with his dog, drinking, and just trying to avoid the entire holiday. We see he's burning a box of pictures. Well, this doesn't exactly sit right with Sam, because in Sam's world, you gotta respect the holiday. You have to respect the traditions. You gotta keep your jack-o'-lanterns lit. You gotta hand out candy. You gotta dress up. All of the above. Respect tradition. So Sam decides to teach the old man a little lesson about holiday tradition, and I do have to tell you that the fight sequences in here and some of the practical effects and some of the practical gore and even a little bit of the CGI throughout here is just fantastic. This scene is what makes Sam truly scary. He is just crazy. I mean, the majority of the film, we actually get to see him with the sack over his head. But it's actually in that scene that we get to see this gorgeous pumpkin beast that you see right behind me. But Sam is just ferocious. And ultimately, the driver believes he's learned his lesson. Sam believes that he has learned his lesson. And he ends up handing out candy to the little girls that are dressed as the three little pigs. Which, by the way, if you've seen that little clip, look at the last of the little girls that is still standing there that says thank you. And also talks about how much she likes his costume. Look at her lips and look at all of that fog, all that smoke coming out. Because how freaking cold was that little girl during that scene for all of that to be going on? That must have been freezing that night. Just saying. Must have been freezing. But across the street, we see Sam's watching him. And it's like, all right, you done good. You done good, kid. Now, this is actually where we get to see the very beginning of the film. And Sam spying our very first victim, who is actually our very last victim, which is the wife of this married couple. And we all know how that ended up, because, yeah. But I gotta tell you, Trick or Treat, I saw it for the first time when I was in college around 2010, 2011, and I fell in love with this movie. It is so well done. I understand, yes, it didn't get the big theatrical release because, you know, studios kind of shy away from a lot of things like that. But this film is fantastic. This film is a gem. And it's honestly become a classic the last several years. So I would highly suggest check it out. If you don't already own a copy, maybe not check out Amazon, because I think it's like $30 last I checked for just a random copy. You know, maybe check out your Best Buy or Target, or even just get it online somewhere. You know, from Amazon. Don't pirate, because we don't support that here on Cinema Figures. But yeah, that is it for this episode of Octogrr. Actually, no, it's not, because I got one more little factoid. If you didn't already know, Trick or Treat originated from a short back from the 1990s, which was called Season's Greetings, that aired on MTV. So, fun little short. I'll stick that up over here, probably. We'll see. Anywho, this is not the only horror anthology that we are going to be getting on Octogrr, but it's definitely my favorite. So this is definitely a movie I have to watch every Halloween, and it is an instant classic. Please do go out and get your own copy of it. You will not be disappointed. So yeah, that is it for this episode. Please do give me a like. Please do comment below and tell me what you love about Trick or Treat. What's your favorite scenes? Do you love Sam as much as I do? Also, subscribe to my channel for more video film-related content, or check out any of the older videos I have up for offer here on Cinema Figures. And until next time, I'm your host, Caitlin. Bye.